Hey guys, it's Allie. Welcome to another Thrifty Tingles, where I visit a local thrift store in search of tingly items to share with you. If you've never seen Thrifty Tingles before, there are three basic rules that I have to follow. Rule number one, I cannot spend over $5. Rule number two, the item or items that I purchase have to be not only tingle-worthy, but also useful to me in my own life. And rule number three, every time I visit the thrift store, I also have to donate something of mine, something that I'm not using anymore, but could be of value to somebody else. So on this trip to the thrift store, the items I donated were some kind of kitchen utensil type items that I didn't need anymore, and also some books that I either had finished or was never going to read. And I'm excited to show you what I found. First, I found two things. Well, three technically. The first two things that I found were this melt and pour soap kit. And what this is, this big green block in here, is just a block of scented soap, evergreen scented. And this also comes with a little plastic mold to make a bar of soap in the shape of a Christmas tree. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Allie, it's springtime. Why would I want a Christmas tree bar of soap? And I agree. So what I decided to do was look around the thrift store a little bit longer to see I could maybe find another type of receptacle for the soap so that I could mold it into a different shape. So I did find something, and that's what I'm going to be doing with you guys today. And the fact that it's evergreen scented, I don't mind, because I like that smell. So even though it might be wintery, I think it's still gonna be cool. So, what I found to pour the soap into, by the way, that was $2.99, about $3. And what I found to pour the soap into was ice cube tray. And I believe this is an IKEA product. But it was 99 cents. And I really have no way of knowing if this is going to work out for me today. It might be absolutely ridiculous, and it might be a complete fail, but it would not be the first time that this has happened on my channel, especially with Thrifty Tingles. Some of you may remember the eggies incident. Anyway, we're gonna find out together. Maybe get a few cute little triangle soaps out of it. Or maybe not. Oh, I also have my binaural microphone here with me today. So second item, technically third, I guess, that I found is also something that I'm not 100% certain about in terms of how well it's gonna work. But again, we're going to find out together. This was only 59 cents at the thrift store, and it's a little thing called eggplants, and this is a ceramic egg that has, I believe, soil and seeds inside of it. And this one has pansy seeds. And you can see it's been, the packaging has been opened and retaped shut. But I don't mind. It's got little fuzzies on it. And so, what you do, and I'll read the instructions in a minute, but you crack open the ceramic at the top and just kind of use this as a little planter, starting planter for, in this case, pansies. So I'm gonna do that. Some of you know how much I love to attempt to grow things. Attempt being the key word. So, these are my items for today's Thrifty Tingles. We're gonna start with the soap. And I'm gonna grab the package and read the instructions to you. And then I'm going to switch shots and attempt to make some soap. I'm gonna read the instructions from our melt and pour soap kit, and then we'll attempt to make some soaps. Step one, cut Delta Soap Creations soap block into pieces approximately 1 inch square. Step two, place a few squares in microwave safe cup and melt on high for 15 seconds. If soap is not completely melted, continue to microwave 5 seconds at a time until soap is just do not overheat. Heat soap just enough to liquefy. Step three. Allow soap to sit until the skin begins to form on the top. Push skin to one side and pour soap into mold. Let soap cool until set. Cooling time varies with room temperature and soap thickness. Soap may be placed in a refrigerator to hasten cooling, but do not freeze. When soap is thoroughly cool, flex the plastic mold until the soap pops out. Okay. So now it's time to cut up our soap into pieces. So I'm going to change. Anything that would not be relaxing. Okay, so as per our instructions, I have my soap block and a big knife, and I'm going to cut it into squares, roughly 1 inch. So let's get started. I can probably cut these into thirds. Done now. Now that that's done, okay. Well, now that that's done, I'm going to go microwave all of our soap. In here is my melted soap, and the directions say to allow it to sit until a skin begins to form on the top, which has already happened really quickly. So now it's time to pour. I'm gonna push the skin over to the side. It's like a little film. Pour the liquid into the mold. Cool. So this actually isn't very much. It's probably not going to make very many of these little triangles. We'll see if we can get a few more. Bunch of soap in there that kind of hardened, so I'm gonna go microwave what's left and see if I can pour that in. But I have to move really quickly. Okay, got a tiny bit more. little triangle. Soaps and the stuff really hardens super, super fast. So yeah, they're already, these at least are already fairly solid. So I'm going to he's in the refrigerator and let them cool off, and then we'll take them out and see how they look. But in the meantime, we can move on to the next item. My interesting little soap making would be really fun. Maybe I'll try doing that and get into it as a hobby. Okay. Let's move on now to the eggplant. Okay. So hardening in the refrigerator, I'm going to try out my newish eggplant thing. It's going to be interesting. Thrifty Tingles, but unfortunately, I don't know, maybe the seeds were too old or the soil was bad or something, but nothing ever sprouted. Very sad. Maybe this will end differently. But maybe not. If nothing comes of my little pansy eggplant, though, I won't despair. New development in my life. Some of you may know that I love tomatoes and will eat them regularly as snacks, just like an apple. I've done that ever since I was a little kid. I don't know why I like them so much. I've heard it suggested that people who eat lots of iron-rich foods like tomatoes, or who crave them a lot, are sometimes anemic, but I really don't think that that's the case with me. I think I just really like them. great hobby in it. And he has more tomato plants than he can, than he needs or than he wants at the moment. So he very kindly brought over two kind of somewhat mature tomato plants with a whole a spoon, which I got right here, to gently crack the top of the egg and remove the broken piece. Add water to growing medium. Smarter than a piece of tape. Possibly not. Okay, here we go. It's a nice sound. I'm gonna do this in the microphone. If you're hearing any voices in the background, I think I might hear some. My neighbors seem to be chatting at a somewhat noisy volume. I'm gonna open up this plastic. This is relevant. It says all this stuff that I told you, but then it also says continue to add water to keep the soil moist. Seeds should germinate in 7 to 14 days. Once the plant is somewhat more mature, repot it into a larger pot with potting soil. Once the plant is fully mature, it will flower. Okey-dokey. Good stuff. Okay, now it's time to attempt to relaxingly crack open this egg. I've never done this. Okay, so my less than gentle taps actually resulted in a bit of a mess over here. This piece just kind of popped off, so let's try some more gentle tapping now. I see why they recommend a blade when you're doing this, because I did not do that part. Some of these little eggshell pieces out of here. Seeds are already in here. So all you have to do is add some water. Bring a bunch of water in. I'll use the spoon to just kind of trickle it in slowly.
7 to 14 days to find out if this was a complete waste of time or not. Although even if it doesn't sprout, or it'll be awesome, and this will be a successful thrifty tingle. So let's find out together, shall we? And I'm going to put this in a place that will get lots and lots of sun. Alright, I think that we just might have some soaps on our hands, folks, which would be a very exciting thing indeed, because I really, really, really did not know how this was going to turn out, and I read just a little bit too late on the package, or on the ice cube tray, somewhere in really small. Ha ha. another one. Just getting one good one is a success in my book. But now we have two. Okay. Now for our next one. This one's gonna be a little bit smaller because I didn't fill it up as much. I feel like Tyler Durden. Soap is a little bit slimy, slippery. I guess that's sort of the nature of soap, though. Seriously, makes me want to start making soap for real. Might be my next craft store trip. Soap making supplies. Okay. Don't fall. This one's a little bumpy. That IKEA. I could put soap in your ice cube trays if I want to. I do what I want. This is cool. I've got a bunch of little soaps. Give these away. Some of them. I'm definitely gonna keep most of them though. Well, I am very, very pleased.
some cute little
slimy green soaps.
And I got a little made this really scary face to haunt your dreams.
Sorry. Wasn't really supposed to be scary.
Okay.
So,
you guys enjoyed this Thrifty Tingles.
Found it interesting and relaxing.
I hope you sleep well and have very pleasant dreams. Seeing you again.
Very soon.
Good night. Now, I understand that you've been experiencing a little bit of shoulder pain, right? Okay, and you think that you might have a torn rotator cuff? Okay. Which shoulder is it that's bothering you? This one, okay. I'm just gonna come in close to you and just kind of feel around where the pain is and just feel for any swelling and inflammation.